Okay. The next item on the agenda is text amendments to the ULDC and an update by Mr. Jason Davenport. Yes, I'm forward.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. These amendments really have minor updates, which is why you have new copies before you this evening. Everything that is changed from you for the text amendments that is in front of you is actually highlighted in yellow. They are minor amendments. We can go through each one very briefly. But ultimately, these amendments stem from a meeting and evaluation by the county attorney. So as a part of that, you'd be happy to address any questions you may have, but otherwise, it'll give me a few moments to run you through and paint those minor amendments in detail, and we can go from there. Ultimately, what we're asking for is a recommendation from you tonight after you hold a public hearing and consider any questions or comments that we receive. If you look, the cover sheet, complete with a timeline, it kind of details some of the activities that we've been going through since April, which is really when serious prep for these amendments began. We put into writing some of the goals and the policies that we've had and the direction we've had on the amendments from 1 through 7. And ultimately, the amendments, if you look, amendment number 1 for variances, minor changes from the county attorney, really clarifications, and then making sure we understand what non-conforming a structure use or sign is. Satisfies really just a language change, converting over to amendment number 2. Tightening up the language when we list the codes. He was not comfortable with us putting down future amendments and additions. He wanted to make sure we only adopt what we currently had in the room, which was fine with us. Shift over to amendment 3 for chickens. He just wanted to make sure we really clarified that crowing hens were not allowed, which is true. And then some language changes. Clarifications on typos if we need it. Amendment number 4. Clarifying how we wrote the OCGA reference, which is where our definition of time comes from. Amendment 5, typically we were planning on doing solar and enforcement with this amendment, but he requested additional time to go through the solar regulations, specifically the decommissioning plan that we spoke about that has to do with a surety bond, which after talking to the county manager, we definitely wanted to accommodate. So we pulled that and we're just going through and doing the enforcement portion, which is really just two sentences, two sections, but happy to talk with any questions you may have about that. But ultimately, we think solar we brought back, but we need to make sure we clear his office first. Amendment 6, OCGA, this is a required amendment for state law to require an appointee for certain appeals and judicial actions in our code. Just various minor typo type changes there, making sure we have the correct OCGA sections. And then finally, daycares, really clarifications of the language for decal, making sure we put it in the right place in our definitions. We found one typo for daycare facilities that we had within there, within our supplemental standards, and I believe in home occupations, we wanted to make sure that it not only applies to employees, but owner, operators, and employees. But ultimately, sir, we believe those are minor amendments. We believe these 7 amendments are ready for your consideration tonight. We'll be happy to go through in additional detail if you would like, but ultimately we are asking for a recommendation. The recommendation, approval with conditions, tabling or recommending denial if we feel that strongly about it. Ultimately, that timeline will show you what kind of public input that we've had. At the end of the day, we are required to have 1 public meeting, 1 public hearing, and 2 notices. We have had the 1 public meeting. Well, we are going to have it as officially the county commission meeting. The 1 public hearing tonight is a hearing, but the official one is in the county commission on July 11th. The 2 notices have been published, 1 to the Daily Times and 1 to Moody. Beyond that, we actually, for this process, are planning on having 6 public meetings. We'll have the 2 public hearings, so 1 above what we're required. We're going to have the 2 required notices. We also will have 2 posts on social media and 2 website updates. So we feel like we are exceeding what we are required to do, but at the end of the day, you have that in writing in case you need.
Thank you, and I'd just like to say that thanks to you and your department. This is something that is long overdue, and some of the issues that you're addressing and improving, I think, will help.
Yes, sir.
And also JD to your department.
Yes, absolutely. JD and Molly, we had a choice this morning after meeting with the attorney of telling you we had changes or actually trying to hustle and put them in writing, and we chose hustle, but it took their help and we wouldn't be able to do without it. So very thankful to kind of bring it to you tonight. And I know they were minor changes, but we in the attorney's office felt like it was worth it to try to put it before you just call them out.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Commissioners, do you understand?
Yeah, I looked at the highlight changes.
Yeah,
Go ahead.
Was it supposed to be 9 or I just...
Yes. Yes, sir. We started at 9. Okay. And then we lost to 1. We really thought we were going to have solar ready for y'all tonight. We had Moody Air Force Base on tap, some comments we received from y'all. But ultimately, that was just not to be, sir. So with solar going out, we feel like the 7 we're putting before you are what we, in fact, want to move forward with.
Okay. And I'm just curious, since our work session, I'm just curious if you have to engage any of the pilots about what they were saying about solar wood panels.
They were going to engage with someone from the range and someone to represent the pilots out there. We felt like with some changes that we were going to be able to address their concerns, but when it came down to that decommissioning plan, which really was outside Moody's concerns, the attorney just was not ready to put something before you yet because he felt like the changes were going to be substantive enough that we just didn't have enough time to get them addressed and back and forth. Okay. So we're going to pull it off, and the next time we come forward with our next round of amendments, we anticipate that being on there.
That's all I have, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Commissioners, any other questions for Mr. Davenport?
So there's no changes to the solar, which is leaving the wall?
No, sir. I mean, we have been able to make it work, you know, for about 15 years, but we recognize that it should be allowed in some other areas per the for a reasonable defense of the code, and so we built that in, but we just are not able to bring that to you just yet. So no, sir, we're not changing the way we do it just yet, but we do think that those changes are going to be helpful, sir.
I think y'all discuss this maybe at the meeting or whatever, but I'm just asking a question
yes,
on that. I know we're not abreast of it now, but as far as the cost of cleanup and who's responsible for it, you did bring that up. And
yes, sir.
That's what you're working on right now.
Exactly.
That was a big concern of mine.
That decommissioning plan.
Like a hurricane or storm comes through with the...
Yes, sir. That decommissioning plan addressed a plan for a cleanup, whether that was... just an end of life after 30 years, a time to replace the solar infrastructure, if there was a problem with the business, or in the case of natural disaster, if they were damaged to a certain extent, who pays for and who cleans up that particular infrastructure. Yes, sir, that is
okay.
That has probably received the most work in the last 2 weeks to make sure they're recovered, and we're close, but we're just not there.
Okay, that's all I got. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Commissioners, I'm going to see if there's anyone here tonight in the audience who may want to comment on this, and then I'll call for a motion thereafter. Is there anyone here tonight that would like to comment on these ULDC text amendments that Mr. Davenport just spoke on? Yes, ma'am. Please come forward. Let your name and address for the record, Gretchen.
My name is Gretchen Quarterman. I live at 6565 Quarterman Road. I get my mail at 3338 Country Club Road. My comments aren't about what is in the text amendments. My comments are on that, in my opinion, the public has not been informed about this satisfactorily. I came to a meeting, I'm going to say, at the end of March, and it was in the other business that this was first presented. It wasn't as an agenda item on the agenda. So if somebody who was interested in the public, they wouldn't have known to come for other business. Then we skipped a month, and we came back, and again, it wasn't on the agenda. I've been waiting a long time for it to be on the agenda. Here we are. And these text amendments have not been on the website. They have not been on social media. The public, the home builders, they've had a chance to look at it, and the salespeople, but the regular folks who are going to be coming to the Zoning Board of Appeals or asking to have their property a little different than it is, they haven't had a chance to see these, so they're not here tonight. And I just, you know, I know lots of times we have public hearings and nobody comes, but the people should have an opportunity to have their say. So I would ask that you please table this until they are public, and that the regular folks can see it in the paper, these are the changes we're going to make. And we've gone, by the way, from 12 to 10 to 7. So, we know that because I keep coming to these meetings.
Thank you. Jason, would you like to comment on any of this, Ms. Waterman's statements?
Sure.
I'm particularly interested about the public not being posted to the public on the website.
Sure. I mean, it has in, if we need to print the website off, or we need to show you something on the phone, we can do that. We can do the same for social media, but at the end of the day, what Ms. Gordon is talking about is she doesn't believe it's been effectively put out for notice for the regular public. And I think that, you know, between six public meetings and two public hearings, a Daily Times notice and a Moody notice, two social media postings and two web postings, I think we are far exceeding what we're required to do. And we can debate what we should do for reaching the public, but I think that from the timeline and the notes that you have, our efforts are clearly showing that we are trying to get the word out there about these amendments. So I welcome, you know, constructive criticism about how to reach the general public without sending, you know, 50,000 people a notice in the mail. But at this point, I think with our resources and our staff, I think you can clearly see that we've tried to put these amendments out there for review. And honestly, the Planning Commission public hearing tonight is an opportunity to get additional press, additional coverage, additional word out there, because these amendments, you know, will go to the County Commission on July 11th. So there's a break between now and then for additional public notice to be done. And so, you know, I welcome comments about how you reach the general public. But at this point, I would just put our reactions and our results in front of you and address that.
So the County Commissioner meeting, you said on July the 11th?
July the 11th.
That's a public hearing to discuss these issues?
It sure is. Yes, sir.
So they don't act on it on the 11th?
Right now, their goal for us was to have something that they would be able to consider on the 11th. But that is their internal goal. JD and I are not aware of any incredibly pressing issue other than, you know, it's been 8 years. Coded and updated, and I think they are ready. We've tried to put a stopgap measure in place. We had one amendment that was due by July 1st and pass potentially a resolution tomorrow to address that. So, you know, our goal right now is to try to accommodate the commissioners and the county manager's direction for this. But at this point, sir, I think they will probably try to act on it, especially with the amendments dwindling down to what we feel like is a very reasonable set of minor amendments.
When was this posted?
So the Daily Times notice was June 18th. The social media was last week, and website-wise, we put them on the website today. So we want to make sure we got it out on that.
So
today.
You have the dates from your.
I want to say social media was last Wednesday, sir. I think it was last Wednesday.
It bothers me a little bit because Gretchen's like a hawk watching stuff like that, you know, and she hadn't seen it, you know, and it was just posted today. So
the paper was the 18th. I want to say social media was last Wednesday, and then, you know, the website, yes, sir, today. We want to make sure we got something out today that was available in that regard. But we've not received any comments or questions to our office that we don't think we have addressed. But at this point, if you feel like that is not enough, it's certainly within your purview to do that.
I think possibly the reason you haven't got comments is because you just posted it today. And
no, sir. I mean, if someone was interested in these amendments, then as of the 18th, but for someone who was really paying attention, and they had noticed before now to contact our office about them. At this point, we've had very few contacts. So, no, sir, I don't think the website posting was a very large factor in our notice.
Yeah, not just the website posting, but everything else, you know, it's just been a week. I mean, how people work, I mean,
sure.
We're required to like an awful short period of time.
So we're required, our minimum notice is 15 days. We cannot go more than 45. If you go 46, we can be taken to court, we can not liable. So we've exceeded the minimums. But again, if you think that we deserve or should take more time, that is certainly within option for y'all to have.
Jason, these texts, is anything like offer in these things?
Sir, I don't think so. I think these are a very nice warm-up to a process that is going to come back to y'all's desks in the coming months. But if the debate is reaching the public at large, I am open to ways to do that. We have made efforts to do that in the past by sending out notices countywide, but that was a huge, very major undertaking, and that was very controversial and important amendments when we did that.
Well, the thing that bothers me the most is we were having a meeting tonight on it, and it was just posted today, so how can people respond to it?
So sir, then again, put documentation and amendments out last week, and even the feelers we put out last week, all someone had to do was contact our office and say they had questions. We did a lot of share information.
I know they can contact your office, but they didn't know anything about it. How do they know to contact your office is what my concern is. I'm on record saying I think you got a short period of time of letting people respond to it when all these new text amendments that we're fixing to make the shiny job, and they're going to act on them on the 11th. That's a hearing, you can call it a hearing, whatever you want to, but they're going to act on them on the 11th, and people haven't had time to.
How much time did you recognize that?
Well, you said you could go up to 45 days. And my point is today is the day you posted it on social media.
And we have a meeting. We posted on social media last Wednesday.
Well, I thought you said today.
No, just the website.
Just the website.
Not everybody's on social media.
Okay. Thank you. Yes. It's my understanding that we will need a motion to pass on our advice to the county commissioners. So the motion can be for approval or delay or whatever. So I'll now entertain a motion on these text amendments that we passed on to the county commissioners.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
In regards to the technical update and the UODC update, text amendment 2023-01, the seven that are presented before us right now, I make a motion that we approve the text amendments that we have in front of us now.
Thank you, Commissioner Bailey. We have a motion for approval. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Second by Commissioner Miller. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Against? So, JD, I guess that means we're suggesting denial to the county commissioners for further study or what?
No. No, motion would be appropriate to determine if you want to table, if you want to make any changes, if you want to add any conditions.
All right. The motion for approval failed. Does some of the disapprovers have a motion?
Yeah, I'll make the motion. I would like to see it tabled for 30 days. You have 45 days, it says, and I would like to give people a little more time to respond to it. I haven't seen it, so I'd like to make a motion that we table it for 45 days and give more time, which they're still going to be able to act on it regardless of what we do here, but at least make a point that we give a little more time for people to look. So I'll make a motion.
Okay. I just want to understand your motion. You're
making a motion to table it for more time for the response.
Second.
You all heard the motion? All in favor? All opposed? You get that, Molly?
So, Mr. Chairman, I'm just curious. If this table 30 days, does Jason have to come back and do his presentation again?
I think it'll depend on what the county commissioners decide.
Yeah.
Yes. That's our proposal, but they'll have the final say as they do in all the cases. Yes.
Just for clarification, the motion was to recommend table.
Yes.
To the Board of Commissioners.
For 30 days.
Right. Okay. It should still be within the 45-day window based on what?
All right, moving on.